ಸೂರ್ಯ ಕಿರಣ್ ಜಿ,
ದಿವ್ಯಾ ರಂಜನಿ,
ತೇಜಸ್ ಸಿ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ,
ರಾಗಿಣಿ ಶೃಂಗಿ,
ವಿಷ್ಣು ಎಂ,
ಶ್ರುತಿ ಕುಮಾರಿ,
ಕಾರ್ತಿಕೇಯ ಚೌಧರಿ,
ಸ್ಮೃತಿ ಶಾಜಿ ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ಯೂ,
ದೀಪಿಕಾ ಮಹೇಶ್,
ಸ್ನೇಹ ಅನಿಲ್ ಕಾರೇಕರ್,
ದಿವ್ಯಾ ಸುಜಾನಾ ಸುನೀಲ್,
ಸುಜಾ ಸುರೇಂದ್ರನ್,
ಸಾಯಿಶಾ ಖುರಾನಾ,
ಸುತಪ್ಪ ಮಜುಮ್ದಾರ್.
LLM in Intellectual Property and Trade Laws, Chaya Shri T,
Sylvia Samuel,
Hema K,
Trisha Singh,
Janani Sridharan,
Veda Shri Kanksha,
Rajarajeshwari S,
Vishnupriya Shivashankar,
Reet Singh,
Deepika S,
S Roshni,
Radhika Goyal,
Saimi Eliza Abraham,
Candidates of Masters in International Studies, Bhargav Acharya,
Shalini K,
Arun Teja,
Seema Balari,
Sagar Kote,
Srujaya Das,
Sachin D.S.,
Sushmita G,
Sai Deepthi.
We present you Shweta K, who is the first rank holder in LLM in Intellectual Property and Trade Laws, securing a CGPA of 3.21.
Akanksha Gansial,
Vibha Amarnath,
Anisha Singh,
Vinnie Victor,
Anju Rose James,
Arun S,
Anna S. Catherine,
Rohit Mohan,
Deepa Shalom Mitra,
LLM in Constitutional and Administrative Law, Benjamin Lakra,
Gayan Gauramba,
Kiran Tirumalesh J,
Gayatri Taluktar,
Aishwarya KP,
Greta and Sam,
Anjita AK.
We present you Harini M, who is the first rank holder of Masters in International Studies by securing CGPA 3.3.
Babita NS,
K. Maya,
P. Manisha,
Niyati Narayan Shetty,
Soumya Shanu,
Parul Kedia,
Sneha Sankla,
Rosita Simon.
We present you Priyanka Vaidyanath, who is the first rank holder in LLM in Constitutional and Administrative Laws, securing a CGPA of 3.31.
Sanya Dikshit,
Mary George,
Shanti S. Nair,
Swikrita R,
Shruti Anup Kumar,
Sameet Karun,
Sukanya Ghosh. Vaidehi Patak, Vatsala Mishra,
Swikrita R,
Jyotirmay Nitin Vyas, Soundarya J, Raghavendra G.L., Siddharth De,
Sameet Karun,
I request all the candidates recommended for admission to the various degrees to kindly stand up. I request Father Chancellor to admit them to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Chancellor of Christ deemed to be university, I hereby admit you to the various degrees, having been examined, certified, and approved by the university. I charge you that ever in your life and conversation You show yourselves worthy of the degree awarded.
Please remain standing. In the convocation ceremonial handbook that you got along with your folders, please turn to page 7 for the graduation pledge. I request Dr. Somo C.S., Associate Dean of School of Law, to administer the pledge.
Please keep your right hand close to your heart and repeat the pledge after me. As a graduate of Christ deemed to be university, I promise to uphold the dignity, honor, and prestige of this university. I will conduct myself with honesty and integrity, taking responsibility for my actions and respecting the rights, opinions, and dignity of all. I will cherish the core values inculcated in me in this temple of learning and will uphold them in the journey of my life. I will use my knowledge, experience, and skills to the best of my ability for the advancement of learning, for the well-being of the community, and for public good. I will strive to create a better society with a sense of fairness, social justice, and an environmental responsibility. I will follow the path of righteousness with respect to all ethical considerations to prove myself a worthy citizen of my country. As I leave the portals of my alma mater, I promise to carry on the good tradition that I belong to in whatever I do, strengthened by the mission and guided by the vision, excellence, and service. I take this pledge by reaffirming my faith in God Almighty, who will always be my guiding spirit.
You may please be seated. Congratulations, dear graduates. This is a momentous occasion for all of you. You have made your parents, teachers, and our university very proud with your achievement today. May I now have the pleasure of inviting the chief guest of the day, Lieutenant General Vipan Gupta, Commandant, Army Service Corps Center and College, Bengaluru, to please deliver the convocation address.
Dr. Father George, the Honorable Chancellor, Dr. Father Thomas, the Vice Chancellor, the other dignitaries on this stage, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure to be standing here this evening and talking to you on this momentous occasion of the graduation ceremony of three prestigious courses of the Institute of Management, School of Law, Department of Professional Studies, and some PhD scholars, 26 of them. My heartiest congratulations to all of you, to your proud parents, and above all, to the teaching faculty who made it possible. Well, I also had a similar training establishment in the Army in Bangalore. It's called Army Service Corps College and Center. Now, we train close to about 20,000 students, basically officers, junior commissioned officers, and other ranks, mostly from Indian Army, but also from the Indian Air Force, Indian Navy, paramilitary forces, and we also get about students from friendly foreign countries. About 15 of the friendly foreign countries students come and they take the various courses that we conduct there. Now, we have established a very, very close bonds with Christ last year when we signed a memorandum of understanding last year in December, basically to get your teaching faculty there and to take the classes. The aim is to share the best practice. And our students really look forward to the lectures given by your teaching faculty. In fact, yesterday, I happened to attend a class which was conducted by one of the visiting professors, Professor Kushil from the Department of Hotel Management. So I was really impressed. Now, our establishment, we want to today make an announcement that so far we haven't done it, but I give a standing invitation to the Vice Chancellor that you can send your students and group of students to our campus to see as to how we conduct the training, how the Indian Army conduct the training. And we also have a whole lot of competitions at the national level and the international level, basically in the horse polo, equestrian sport, martial art, and the bodybuilding. You will also be glad to know that our motorcycle display team last year, on the 19th of November, set a world record in which they put 58 persons on single motorcycle. It is there in the Guinness Book of World Records. So I welcome all the students and the faculty to visit our campus and see as to how do we conduct our training. On this very important day, when you leave the portals of this prestigious and elite institute of yours and enter into a competitive world, remember, there are people there who will rate you, there are people there who will shake you, and some of them even hate you. But how firmly you stand on your two feet, that's what's going to make you. So I thought I'll give you some of my thoughts. You can call it as advice, you can call it as success mantra. They have definitely helped me to reach where I have reached today, and I'm sure they will also help. My first advice to you is that last 3-4 years that, or whatever time that you've spent here, you have been given a thorough of information. You have been given a lot of knowledge by your teachers. So that was their responsibility. But now that you are ready to go out in the open world, your responsibility is to convert that knowledge into wisdom. And how do you convert knowledge into wisdom? By applying it practically, innovatively, and creatively to solve various assignments, projects that will be given to you when you go for your assignment. Now, you must, knowledge that you gain here, it has to be shared, because if you keep the knowledge with yourself and you don't share it, it is neither good to you nor it is good to the organization. So you should never hold back your views. You must be very forthright. If you don't do that, then somebody will get tempted to say that what good are wings? if you don't have the courage to apply? Or what good is knowledge if you don't have the ability to share that knowledge, convert that knowledge into wisdom, and solve various problems? My second mantra, or the second advice to you, is you must stay curious and inquisitive like a child. As a child, we used to ask so many questions to our parents, to our friends, to our siblings, and that is how we used to add to our knowledge. But unfortunately, what happens as we grow old, we start feeling that we know everything, and then we hit a dead end. Now, we should never do that, and we must continue to build the knowledge bank, and we must follow the Gandhian philosophy, which says, I'm sure all of you are aware of that, that we must live as if we were to die tomorrow, and we must learn as if we were to live forever. Now, my third advice or third point to you is that you must develop reading as a habit. Reading is the most prestigious or the most profitable investment that you can venture into. It's a high-powered, low-cost option to learn. And the good news is that all of us have got equal amount of access to the books, to the magazines, to the articles. All that we need to do is that just walk up to the library, pick up some books and read, professional or non-professional. Imagine the kind of knowledge, imagine the kind of experience that goes into writing a book by the author. And how much time does it take for you guys or all of us to imbibe that knowledge? Just a couple of hours, maybe a couple of days. A well-read man can stand out in any group setting. The next point that I have is, which is almost a related point to this, and that's a very empowering tool that all human beings have, but unfortunately, we don't utilize that, most of us. And that tool is the art of listening. Let me repeat, the art of listening. We stay physically present, but mentally we are somewhere else. We are brooding something in our mind. They say that the listening is more powerful than speaking. Why? Because when I'm speaking to you, when I'm talking to you, I already know what I'm talking to you. But when I listen, I add a lot of knowledge because I may get a lot of inputs from you. We must develop this art of listening. The next point is that we must anticipate here, somebody mentioned here, and we must be prepared for it. The world is changing at a very fast pace. The way we have changed in the last couple of decades, it is unbelievable. And it's going to happen even faster in the future. We are entering into the era of artificial intelligence, where even the human mind can be hacked. So you must be prepared for accepting any change. Change is the only constant. You have two options. One option is that you can respond to the mayhem of change. And the second option is that you can be the initiator of change. Be the change that you want to see. There are a number of scholars, there are a number of people who have spoken a lot about the management of change. First, I've heard the name of Rumi, the poet or the mystic of 13th century. He said that, I was clever yesterday as I was trying to change the world. And I'm wiser today because I'm changing myself. Something similar was said by Charles Darwin when he said that it is not the most strongest and the most intelligent species that's going to survive, but the one which can change itself proactively. So these are the timeless wisdom given by these scholars. So we must be adaptive to change. The next point that I have is that you all must develop the leadership traits. Whether it is a civil world or a corporate world or the Indian Army or the armed forces, leadership traits are required everywhere. Now, the good news is that the leaders are made and leaders are not born. The last point that I have is that you must learn to think big. Unless you think big, you cannot achieve big. All those who operate and all those who are happy by doing small, small things, they achieve or they end up achieving insignificant goals. You must have the courage to think big, because whatever you want to achieve, that is first manifested in your mind and then it is manifested on ground. That is why they say that the boys and girls who dare to dream are the one who turn into men and women of vision. The same thing has been said in our Upanishads, and I quote, "As your dream is, so is your will." I repeat, "As your dream is, so is your will. As your will is, so is your deed. And as your deed is, so is your destiny." Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It was a pleasure talking to you. Jai Hind.
After that inspiring convocation address, may I now call upon Honorable Chancellor, Dr. Father George Ediadiel, to address the gathering.
Honorable Chief Guest of the Day, Lieutenant General Bibin Gupta, Colonel Dr. Father Thomas C. Matthew, the Vice Chancellor, Dr. Father Abraham V.M., the Pro Vice Chancellor, Guest of Honor Dr. Spawn Holds, Dr. Anil Pindo, the Registrar, Professor Joni Joseph, the Controller of Examinations, Mr. Jugnu Abroy, President of the Alumni Association, Deans, Associate Deans, Reverend Fathers, staff, parents, and well-wishers. My dear graduates of the Institute of Management, Professional Studies, School of Law and Research, you are the brain center and the pride of this university with your learning, professional competence, skills, and research mind. We all join you to celebrate your hard-earned achievements. Congratulations. The whole campus looks young, lively, and elegant with your radiating presence. The Greek philosopher Aristotle said, "Philosophy starts from wonder. Then the first philosopher is the child." The search for truth lies at the heart of all learning process and the growth of human civilizations. The Bible we read, "Unless you become like a child, you will not enter into the kingdom of God." We may say, "Unless you become like the children, you will never embrace the truth." Born simple and innocent, we ourselves are becoming more and more complex day by day, and hence the truths go far away from us. Let us not be in the world of illusions. About the mystery of truth, Isaac Newton wrote, "I do not know what I may appear to the world, but to myself, I seem to have been only like a boy, playing on the seashore, diverting myself in, now and then, finding a smoother pebble or a prettier shell than ordinary, whilst the great ocean of truth lay all undiscovered before me." My dear Christites, I hope and pray that the years of learning and research did not spoil the child within. Keep alive the child within, as the Chief Guest already said. Then life will be happy, enthusiastic, and hopeful. My dear graduates of the Institute of Management, Professional Studies, School of Law and Research, you are called to make a difference with your vision, skill, expertise, and experience. You are to be the visionaries, architects, and leaders of our nation and the world, with a genuine human face which takes care of the poor and marginalized, touched by the divine spark within. The last few years you spend your quality time and energy in the campus. You surely have absorbed the culture of Christ and its vision, mission, and core values. Simultaneously, you have enriched her by your valuable presence and achievements. Thank you so much for being part of the university. Let our language, spoken and unspoken, and our actions manifest the healthy culture, discipline, commitment, and the worldview that you have imbibed from this campus. Today, our chief guest has given us the pearls of wisdom and the mantras that will help us on the way of life. Today, we have with us the Lieutenant Colonel. All these days we have Vice Chancellors from various other universities to be the Chief Guest. But today we have the Lieutenant General, so our Colonel, our Vice Chancellor will be happy today, I think. This year we have to celebrate the Golden Jubilee of our alma mater. Dear Christites, you are most welcome to make it a grand success in collaboration with the president of our alumni association, Mr. Jugnu. We have in our colonel, our vice chancellor, Father Thomas, a visionary leader, a brilliant educationalist, a great administrator, challenging personality, and an exemplary religious. His vision, conviction, willpower, focused mind, inclusive and holistic outlook made this university one of the most prestigious learning centers in India today. Once in a casual conversation, he told me, "Dream is a paisa, whereas realization of it is million." Father, you have made one paisa into millions in Christ through your unique leadership. We are all proud of you, Father Thomas. You make us proud of being part of Christ University. I do appreciate and acknowledge the entire teaching and supporting staff and the collaborators who work as a team to make Christ a much sought after university. Congratulations to all teaching and service staff of the university. Also, I wish you thank you, the parents and the guardians, for entrusting your dear ones in our care. The university has tried to do justice to your dreams. I thank also the media for your presence, my dear graduates. As you go out in search of your chosen career paths and in your future endeavors, let the memories strengthen you. A friend once shared a Hindi poem with me. Aadmi musafir hai, aata hai jata hai, aate jate kuch yaadon chhod kar jata hai. Human being is a pilgrim. He comes and goes, leaving behind some memories. We believe that Christ University has given you memories, experiences, expertise, and perspectives of envisioning a better future, not just for you alone, but for your families, for the society, and the nation at large. Remember, perseverance is the toughest road, but the surest path to success. Let us remember the ancient quote: when you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. Let us carry on in life with positive attitudes to create a better world for all. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Let all beings be happy and peaceful. May the divine presence accompany you and your dear and your ones wherever you are. May God bless you. Jai Hind.
After the blessings from the Honorable Chancellor, I invite the President of Christ University Alumni Association, Mr. Jugno Oberoi, to give the felicitation address. Mr. Oberoi is from the first batch of Christ in 1969.
By God, too many speakers for my graduation day. When will this fat guy be over so that we can take pictures with our batchmate and parents? Yes, this is exactly what I was thinking way back in the same college during my graduation too. Only that time we took black and white camera pictures with our batchmates being all guys. True, unfortunately, it was not a co-ed college in my time. While today, you have these charming ladies dressed in the best Indian look, and that too, you take colored pictures. Jealous, I am. That's why, when I met Bishop Father Kariel, the principal, who introduced co-ed in this campus in the late 1980s, I asked him, why were the fathers so harsh with us that we had an all-boys college? Plus, that was the reason I had to go across the seas to find my own better half. Father smiled and replied, Jugno, during your time and the batches after you, we found the students' attendance going down in classes while their visits to the gates of Mount Carmel and Jyoti Nivas was going up. So we fathers thought it best to bring both Mounts and Jyoti into Christ. So my friends, that is my time in college. Christites, lend me your ears. I stand before you as a very frightened speaker, but a proud Christite. Before I bore you with my address, we all have a duty today. The MC introduced us to a Vice Chancellor in Honorary Colonel Dr. Father Thomas. Personally had the privilege of spending over 18 years with him, and to me, we can assure you all that we are very, very fortunate to get such a fine gentleman who led this institution to unbeatable heights. Unfortunately, the rule of law does not give him another convocation, and this would be the last with your group. Christites, please stand up and join me in giving the loudest applause we have ever given in this auditorium to him. Thank you. I think you really deserved that. I'm also afraid my voice is going to crack, as last night, in celebration of your graduation, had a few drinks. This morning found the reason for the bad throat. The drink was good, but the ice was bad. Christites, as your senior, my first advice to you is always avoid ice in your drink. Now let me rush back to my formal boring algebra class address, otherwise Father VC will fine me for spoiling today's decorum. The right head to lead us into our golden jubilee celebration, our learned Chancellor, Dr. Reverend Father George. I'm very pleased today to have someone who keeps awake full night so that we could sleep safely in our beds. Our guest of honor in Lieutenant Colonel Vipin Gupta, my salams and Ram Ram to you, sir. The wounded soldier on duty, our commanding officer and today's passing out regiment, Honorary Colonel of the Indian Armed Forces, Reverend Father Dr. C. Thomas, every alumni's friend and Bajrangi Bhai in Pro Vice Chancellor, Father Abraham, Dr. Father Abraham, respected fathers, Dr. Anil, the fine gentleman registrar, every student's enemy, as he refuses to give us any grace marks, control of examination, Professor Johnny Joseph. Our strength in this university, deans, HOD, faculty, non-teaching, and my German friend, Professor Uwe Danke, for being here from all the way from Germany. Happy parents, invitees, ladies and gentlemen, and above all, today's proud fellow graduating battalion of Christites. My namaskaram, sat sri akal, and a very good evening. Walaikum salam, and a very good evening to one and all. Graduation day is an event which every student looks forward to, for it's today one changes from a youth to a man. From a youth to a man, to a girl to a woman, ready to face the challenging world on their own feet. I recall my own graduation over 45 years back, and remember, we too had some fine speakers giving us some sound advice, an advice which many of us took into our pathway of life, where it helped us build our future. This day, you had received some great advice from speakers before me, and I urge you, keep that in mind. Let me, now as your senior, add a very small bit to their thoughts. I'm not going to remind you your tomorrow needs hard work, etc., as I'm sure your years in this college has been grilled enough into every Christite. At the outset, I carry the greetings of thousands of your fellow Christites who have walked out of this institution with their heads held high. Today, I just wish to remind you of two very important aspects in our life which we tend to forget, that we are Indians first and our culture is still appreciated by the West while we are trying to ape them. As we grow older, we not only forget, but also do not give them the due respect which society and we all need to give. The first is a fraternity which is treated like the oldest profession in the world. I'm pained to hear students tell me, "But sir, I paid my fees, so why care or remember them?" Let's not forget that they have given us their entire wealth, their wealth of knowledge, and no money can buy this wealth. For if it was so, each one of us would have been a Bill Gates or a Narayan Murthy. Yes, friends, I am thinking about our teachers. I will share today with you a true story of a student and his teacher. The student is yours truly, Jugnu, and the teacher was my third standard school teacher called Mrs. David. I did my schooling at Baldwin's Boys, Bangalore. Mrs. David was my class teacher when I should have been around 10 years of age and around 15 kgs in weight. I had not seen her since leaving school more than 50 years back, though I remembered she was a very pretty lady whom we all adored. A few years back, the principal of Baldwin's invited some senior alumni to request us to plan an event at the school for celebrating its 125 years. So we seniors, around 10 heads, formed a core group and planned to hold a ball at the Leela Hotel called Down Memory Lane. In this group was Akash Rayal, the current director of Bethany High School, also a fellow Christite. We became good friends and I came to know Mrs. David was his mother. As we had to meet regularly, we then suggested each will host a dinner meet. When Akash's turn came, he offered to host it at his school, as it gave us an opportunity to see his school, plus told him I would love to meet my teacher, his mother too. The day dawned. We met at his office and after the meeting, proceeded to the boys' dining hall for dinner, where his mother, Mrs. David, was welcoming each one of us. Please, my friends, hear this part of the story. When my turn came, Akash told his mother, "Ma, this is one of your students. Do you recognize him?" For a few seconds, she looked into my eyes and addressed me by a name. Akash immediately came and he said, "No, Ma, this is Jugnu. You have forgotten him. It's so, so long back. You had taught him." I stopped Akash and told him, "You're wrong, my friend. My teacher has addressed me by my very correct legal name, a name which today only my bankers and my auditors know, an official name with which I sign my business instrument. Jugnu is my pet name. After my education, somewhere down, it got stuck both in my private and official circle. Christites, the same was repeated to me 15 years back when I honored my teacher, Benny Sir, who taught me economics in the year 1969 at this very same college. He too addressed me by that name. What I am trying to stress here is a fraternity who, like our parents, never ever forget each one of us. Then why do not we give them the due respect of at least dropping by and informing them the plant they have watered has given fruit? Will see a joy of happiness in their eyes. Do remember, our scriptures tell us, we bow to our gurus first, then the Lord above. My Christites, later this part of this evening, I urge you to spend parting with your friends. A glass of beer or wine is also welcome, as you will shortly bid farewell to your benchmate of the last few years, for you do need to celebrate the last 15 to 20 years of your hard work you have put to reach today's function. But before that, go home. Thank the old couple as you youngsters address your dear parents. Carry a rose, a card, a chocolate, or give them a jadu ki japi. Or just say two words, thank you, and take their blessings for walking the distance with you in these last over 20 years of your growth. Do recall, just at a drop of a hat, you've asked your mother to wake you up at 4 a.m. to study for an exam, and the poor lady tosses, turns the whole night in fear that she may miss the alarm, wakes up much earlier, makes you that hot cup of coffee, and then repeatedly tries to wake you up. Remember the number of times your dear father quietly kept his necessities so that you could buy and enjoy some luxury during your time in college. If possible, which is very hard, I know, these days, do tell them you will guide them in their twilight years. My fellow Christites, I do not recall if I have said these words to my parents. Even today, I long to say so, but unfortunately, fate has separated us. Let history not be repeated with you. Here, I leave you with some thoughts of a touching story. After his father's death, the son decided to leave his mother at an old age home, where he visited her off and on. One day, he received a call from the old age home saying, "Your mother is very serious. Please come and visit her." The son went and saw that his mother was very critical and on her dying bed. He asked her, "Ma, what can I do for you?" She replied, "Please, son, can you install fans in this old age home as there are none? Also, can you put a fridge for the betterment of food?" Son was surprised and said, "Ma, while you were here, you never complained, but now you have a few hours left. Why are you telling me and asking of me this all? Why, please tell." He replied, "Beta, it's okay, dear. I have managed the heat and the hunger and the pain. When your children will send you here, I'm afraid you will not be able to bear it." My Christite, that is a parent who, even in the last breath, will always remember you. Why do not we give them the love and respect they deserve? I can go on and on, giving you many stories of misdeed, but time today is not with me. In the lighter tone, coming back to your alumni association, I do hope each of you have registered in our webpage. It's free of cost, and through it, you'll be able to keep in touch with the activities of your association as well as the updates and happening in the university campus. Particularly from July this year, we celebrate various events as a campus towards our Golden Jubilee year. I also invite any of you youngsters to join my core team and help us bring the association to a greater height. Do mail me if you're interested to be a part of my team. Some of our activities, like the fee concession scholarship which we give to needy Christites, is very close to my heart. The Fun Fiesta, a day for our faculty staff, is in August this year, which will be followed by a health camp for everyone on the campus. Our AGM is in October. Then we hold the very popular Alumni Family Day on 26 January, which will be a very huge program this year, being the 50-year celebration. And admission for this is going to be strictly on RSP and seats, for which we will be sending invites on your webpage. So, as usual, we get a few thousand alumni coming. So, I request you, please, if you're interested to attend on that day, do register and block your seats much in ahead. I seem to have crossed my time, but before I bid you best, I would like to share a poem which my late father gave me the day I graduated. Even today, when I'm in difficulty, I read it in a corner as it reminds me that I and I alone have to face the trouble. He called it an odd philosophy of life. Excuse me. He called it an odd philosophy of life. Man comes into this world without his consent, leaves it against his will, and while on earth, he is misguided and misunderstood. In infancy, he is an angel. In boyhood, he is a devil. And in manhood, he is a fool. If he has a wife and children, he is a chum. And if he is a bachelor, he is inhuman and mean. If he enters a public house, he is a drunkard. And if he stays out of it, he is a miser. If he is poor, he has no brain. If he is rich, he has all the luck in the world and is a crook. If he goes to the temple, he is an hypocrite. And if he stays away, he is a sinner. If he gives charity, it's for advertisement. If he does not, he's stingy. When he comes into this world, everybody wants to kiss him. Before he leaves this world, everybody wants to kick him. If he dies young, he has a great future. And if he lives to a ripe old age, everybody hopes he has made a will. It is therefore impossible to please everybody. So do your duty, be fearless, use your common sense, which is so uncommon. And if you make mistakes, it's better than doing nothing else. Hence, keep smiling. Nobody wants to hear about your troubles, as each of them have wagon loads of their own. Signing off, I'll just say, mere dost, kabhi alvida mat kehna. The gates of Christ University are always open for its alumni. God bless you. Jai Hind.
After that felicitation, representing the graduates, Karthik Krishnan from the Institute of Management will now share his experience during his academic journey in this university, which will be followed by the university choir rendering the farewell song.
Graduation ceremony is an event where the commencement speaker tells thousands of students dressed in identical caps and gowns that individuality is the key to success. I am Karthik Krishnan S, and I feel proud that I have been selected to deliver the farewell speech on behalf of the students of Center for Research, Department of Professional Studies, Institute of Management, and School of Law. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished chief guests, special invitees, members of the management, faculty of Center for Research, Department of Professional Studies, Institute of Management, and School of Law, graduating students, and of course, the architects of today's show, the proudly smiling parents. Some journeys start and end at different places, but some journeys like ours at this Christ University started in this auditorium and is going to end in the very same auditorium today. The day when we started our journey in this university, we looked at the campus, we looked at the ambience, we also looked at all the fantastic facilities available here and said to ourselves, boy, we are going to have some fun. But n number of CIAs, rigorous exam schedules, SIP project accompanied by placements, and life skills training had some other plans. We balanced this beautifully and managed to have fun without compromising on other aspects of life at Christ University. The student who enters this university with big dreams will now walk out as a person who is ready to take on the world and its challenges. And that, my friends, is what this university has done for us. It has transformed each one of us to not only become better managers, but also to become better human beings, one with the right morals and ethics. I am proud to be part of the batch that has been the best in terms of academics, extracurricular, and placements. Yes, we have flourished, and I would like to thank the people who have been a catalyst in this process. Thank you to the management for being the enablers and making things happen for us. Thank you to the faculty for helping us understand that learning has never an ending. We need to learn, unlearn, and relearn. Thank you to the people in the office, the placement committee, the librarians, the security guards, and the housekeeping team, and all other support staff for making our lives so much easier. It would never be the same without you. Your dedication and care is wonderful and much appreciated. A big thanks to the parents and families of the students graduating today who have supported us in our endeavor to become successful graduates. And finally, to the graduates, we have worked hard, we have had our share of fun. It's now time to go out there and make history. Let us give a big round of applause to all of the above and show our gratitude to them. Allow me to quote Mr. Tom Brokaw here. You are educated. Your certification is in your degree. You may think of it as the ticket to good life. Let me ask you to think of an alternative. Think of it as your ticket to change the world. Pleasure to have shared a memorable time with all of you. God bless us all and all the best for your life's head. March on, Christites, march on. Thank you.
Keep the love that keeps us strong.
After the moving farewell speech, with the permission of Honorable Chancellor, I now declare the convocation ceremony closed. I now invite Professor Divakar GM, Faculty Institute of Management, to propose the vote of thanks.
While congratulating all our postgraduates for having been conferred with the much coveted degrees and ushered into a distinguished league of their own, let me take this occasion to thank all those who have made this convocation 2018 a dream come true. I would like to place and record my profound gratitude to Honorable Chancellor Dr. Father George Eriadil for presiding over today's convocation ceremony. Your blessings to our students in conferring the academic distinction and for your wise counsel. For these acts of kindness, we remain ever grateful to you. Thank you, Father. It is indeed an honor to have with us our esteemed chief guest, Lieutenant General Vipin Gupta. Sir, we are grateful to you for happily accepting our invitation, spending your valuable time with all of us today, for wishing the graduates personally, and for your passionate convocation address. I'm sure your address will linger on our minds as we strive, make our own path, and reach out to others. Thank you, sir. I request our Honorable Chancellor to present a memento to Lieutenant General Vipin Gupta as a mark of our respect and appreciation of his gesture. Thank you, Father. It is indeed our privilege that Dr. Uwe Sponholz, Dean, University of Applied Sciences, FHWS, Germany, is with us in this August gathering. He has traveled all. I wish our graduating students, I express my profound gratitude to you, sir. Our beloved Vice Chancellor, Colonel Dr. Father Thomas C. Matthew, has always been a personification of passion, compassion, and reason, and stands like the Rock of Gibraltar behind our expeditions. Father, your inspiring words and encouraging gestures have enabled our students to take their academic journey to its logical end, and I take this opportunity to profusely thank you for the same and your stewardship in this organization of this ceremony. Thank you, Father. I'm immensely thankful to the Board of Management, Pro Vice Chancellor, Dr. Father Abraham VM, Registrar Dr. Anil Joseph Pinto, Controller of Examinations Professor Johnny Joseph, Chief Finance Officer Father Joby Xavier, Dean, Associate Deans, other Fathers, Directors, Heads of the Department, Faculty Members Mr. Juguni Oberoi, President Alumni Association, and invitees for their gracious presence and valuable patronage in organizing this ceremony. I'm extremely thankful to the Student Welfare Office, Mr. Bhaskar and his team, technical and logical support by Mr. Rajan and team, our university choir, student volunteers of various deaneries, Lieutenant Sajina Begum, Lieutenant Dinesh, and their team of NCC cadets who have thrown their might in successfully organizing this convocation ceremony. Let me also thank the proud parents and guardians who have made a point to be with their wards on this special occasion in their lives. Your sacrifice, prayers, and support have culminated into your children reaching the logical end of their academic odyssey. Thank you, parents. Dear graduates, I thank you all for being here today and for your cooperation in the smooth conduct of this ceremony. You leave this ceremony with a duty to uphold the good name of Christ, deemed to be university, as your alma mater. It is our hope that wherever you are and whatever you do, you will uphold the spirit of this institution. May God bless you abundantly. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, I want to state that we are all most grateful to be present here today. We thank you for being with us this evening. It's been a great pleasure. Thank you.
Please rise for the national anthem.
जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता।
remain standing as the dignitaries leave the auditorium. Please be seated. Guests and invitees are requested to remain seated as the graduates leave the auditorium. Graduates are requested to report to their assigned rooms for returning the robes. Have a great evening.